Hello friends, welcome back to our channel Nursery to Asvi. Today it will be our second lecture on shell scripting. So let's learn more on shell scripting using Ubuntu Virtual Machine. So let's open Linux Ubuntu Virtual Machine on our host OS. So I open Ubuntu Virtual Machine to give you a demonstration on shell scripting. So now you have to create a file. So you have to type sudo to give administrative privileges to our operating system. Now type touch and name of file, I'm giving nur2.sh, and now I have to type password. Now you have to open the text editor. For that you have to write sudo nano and you can see the text editor has been opened for you to write the script. So earlier in this lecture series, we have seen how to print strings on shell and how to add commands into your script. Now let's see how to initialize the variables and how to use them in our shell. So for that you have to first give the location of the shell. So for that you have to type hash, then bang, then you have to give the path of your shell, that was bin. sh. Now you have to, for initializing any variable, you just have to type the name of variable like nursery. Without giving any space, you have to write the value of variable you want to assign it, like I want to assign it 32. Let's use one more variable. Now for printing these variable, you have to write echo space and you have to use the sign of dollar and the name of variable. And you have to save the script. Control X, Y, Enter. Now as you run the script, nur2.sh, permission denied. So you have to give the permission using chmod 755 nur2.sh. You have to act as super user for granting permission. Now you have to run the file and you can see the variable's value has been printed on your console. So that's how you can initialize and use the variables in your shell. There are some commands I want to teach you through this lecture. Like there is a command help, which give you a list of some basic commands used in that OS. So type help and you can see the list of some basic commands has been printed on your shell, which you can see and use them. And if you want to know some of the specific command, you have to type man and you have to type the command about which you want to know, like mkdir, and you can see the description, name and synopsis has been printed on your screen so that it can help you know about the command in deep. And if you will type q, and it will take you back to your shell. And if you type clear, it will clear the shell. That's all for today's lecture. Hope you have enjoyed watching this lecture. If you have any queries, feel free to ask them all in comment section below or mail us at nur2var@gmail.com. Like, share, subscribe and follow us on Twitter, Facebook, LinkedIn and Instagram. Thank you. Stay tuned.